Happy New Year and welcome to the very first feed dump of 2014. This week, we are all, predictably, New Year's resolutions. I am, of course, eat less and exercise more. Joining me this week is Floss.
Right.
And uncovering the hidden secrets of the male orgasm.
Wait, what?
And of course, we're likely to do all of that. The Phoenix Coyotes may be the unluckiest team in the history of the NHL after their own goalie scored a goal against their team by doing what?
Playing the puck behind the net.
No.
Celebratory puck toss after making a save.
No.
Long shot to the other end, bounces off a player and comes back.
Nope.
By putting the puck in his own net.
Ding, 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 ding! The puck got lodged in his pants during a scuffle, and it fell out the back of his trousers into the net.
He shits, he scores!
Time-honored hockey advice is to keep your head up and shit the puck.
Wait, I can do hockey stuff too! Check your five hole.
That's not applicable in this situation, but just good life advice in general.
Red Bull might give you wings, but if you need the crazy strength of a raging bull elephant, why not try meth? A man in Oregon fought off 15 cops while masturbating in a bar over the Christmas holidays.
Barkeep, can I get a stiff dink?
Warning! Bad pun!
Seriously though, this feat is actually quite impressive. 15 cops while masturbating? That's perseverance. I mean, you could put a photo of that on a motivational poster.
Perseverance. When tweaking on meth and jerking it in public, never let the opposition bring you down.
To make it even more impressive, not only did he manage to beat off while beating off 15 cops, they tased him multiple times first to try and get him subdued.
Isn't this just Electro's origin story?
So if you're keeping score at home, while Google shows many results for mixing meth and alcohol with fighting the police, and for electro cock and ball torture, no one has managed to combine the two genres until now, so well done, you sexed up cop-punching tweak freak.
And with that, we've unlocked the mystery of the male orgasm.
I'll get the dental floss.
And now it's time for a very special new feed dump feature that I'm inventing right now because Graham's not around to tell me I can't. It's the Year in News Review Quiz!
I didn't ask for this.
I like quizzes.
Question one. God may be in everything, but he probably was taking a coffee break when the architect designed the Christian Science Dixon Church in Illinois, which looks like what from above?
A swastika. I'm not saying that.
A swastika?
Matt?
It's a penis, isn't it?
First blood goes to Wiggins! It does indeed look like a curvy schlong from above.
It had dicks in the name. What else was it gonna be?
In slightly more down-to-earth news, an image of what appeared in the folds of a dog's butt hair?
Another dog?
Miley Cyrus.
Pope Francis with a dick in his mouth?
Jesus Christ!
For someone who didn't ask for this, you're doing awfully well. Matt, again, gets another point. It was, in fact, Jesus.
It's important to remember that it's fishin' loaves, not pinchin' loaves.
Second warning!
You know, I feel like we're doing a major disservice to Christianity here, but to be honest, I saw the picture and... Guys, your savior's in a dog's butthole.
Time to make these a little harder. I'm sure you guys heard about the town in the UK that was terrorized by a guy dressed as a clown just standing around creeping people out. But can you name that town?
Nope.
Nope.
Make an effort!
Frightwig upon grease paint?
North Clowngashire.
This year, an Australian man famously stuck what up his pee hole in order to receive sexual gratification?
Stingray barb.
Some sort of device?
More specific, Beige.
Some sort of round device?
No, sexier.
A coat hanger.
What? No, it was a fork. What?
In fairness to Beige, coat hanger ostensibly fits up a pee hole. How the hell do you get a fork in there?
Perseverance.
Kathleen, we did this story already.
And finally, Henry Gribom of Epsom, New Hampshire, complained to police after losing $2,600, his entire life savings, and winning what in return?
The laughter of a small child.
A lifetime supply of vanilla pudding.
A bag full of dog anuses.
Jesus Christ!
No, we did that story already.
Sadly, all of that would have been better than what he did win, which was a 6-foot-tall Rasta banana plush toy.
I don't know what this guy was complaining about. That prize is quite appealing.
Final warning!
$2,600 for that? I paid 20 for mine! The carny wanted 40, but he took the 20 because it still had cocaine on it.
Wow, okay, I'm just gonna call feed dump before anybody else gets offended, which I think is probably too late, but whatever, and Happy New Year! And remember, there may be better sources for news, but they don't have this hat, because this hat is actually my crown, and it is a reminder that I am still doing that Kathleen Romanian princess running gag in 2014. Why not, Kathleen? A chicken in every house, a cat in every house, a chicken in every cat! You could do worse.
$2,600 for that? I paid 20 for mine, and the only reason the carny took it is because the bill still had cocaine on it. No shit, I paid 20 for mine! Carney wanted 40, but the... The carney wanted 40, but he took the 20 because it still had... Fuck, I'm so close!
So close.
Oh!